What is up, YouTube? I'm on a horse with no name. Actually, he may have a name, I don't really know. But anyways, we're on a horse. And we're on our way to go see the butterflies here in Michoacan. And it's kind of a dull day, so I'm not really sure. Okay, I'm not really sure which way. Okay, the horse is going in a whole nother direction. Oh. Oh. Okay. Vámonos. Vámonos. Hey. Ah. The guide's gonna go get the other horse. He left me with this one. No. Just looking to see if the guide is gone. So check out this mountain scenery that we got here. You know, this area is known for its butterflies, but unfortunately I think that the butterflies are going to be pretty much dormant because of the temperature, and there's not a lot of sun. And usually what the locals have been telling us is that you need a lot of sunshine for the butterflies to come down from the trees. So I don't know, we're gonna go see. So as soon as we've arrived up at the top here of these mountains, it has started to drizzle, and oh man, that was the one thing that I was kind of hoping would not happen. Because there are a couple trails, we're trying to find these butterflies. Hopefully the rain isn't too bad and we can still at least see them when they're in their little, I don't know if the right word is hive, but they're all bunched up together because of the cold. Let's go check on my parents, see how they're doing. It was kind of a risk to come because we saw the cloud, and we saw that the sun had peeked its way through a couple times, but we figured, you know what, let's risk it. And then we said, we know we're already here. And so yeah, we're gonna be in the town of Aporo for a few days, so we may get another chance to actually come see the butterflies on a day when there is some sunshine. As you guys probably noticed, we've been exploring the state of Michoacan quite a bit, and that's because even though I'm from Guanajuato, the little pueblo that I'm from, Yuriria, is really close to the border with Michoacan. And Michoacan has, as you can see, a lot of natural beauty and a lot of unique places and towns. So my goal is to kind of explore things that are nearby and then expand my horizons out to the other states in Mexico. Oh man, the rain's coming down pretty hard. So that's all I'm trying to do. And I'm trying to take you guys on this adventure with me. So I hope you guys are enjoying it. Our guide Lupita told us that we need to be really quiet. I guess the noise, we don't want to disturb the butterflies. Looks like she's showing us something here. All right, YouTube, we got rained out, so we're gonna have to catch up with you guys on another day. All right, what is up, YouTube? It's a whole different day, and actually, we're on our way to actually hopefully see the butterflies today. As you can see, it's a lot warmer, the sun is out, and that is actually what gets the butterflies going and flying around. We're just 20 minutes away here. When we saw them the other day, they were actually just all nested together because of the cold and the rain. But hopefully today, because it's a little bit warmer, a little bit more sun, that there's a lot more butterflies flying around. And I don't know, I'm excited to, the horse is excited, I'm excited, everyone's excited. I see some of you guys judging me for riding this horse, but really one of the reasons we decided to take the horse was because I'm worried about my dad's knee. And the hiking all the way up, and then particularly, I know he finds it difficult walking down. So we decided to take the horse, and you know, it's also an experience. I'm not gonna lie, I'm having a good time on here. Poor guy's doing all the work, you know. But yeah, I'm excited to get up at the top. I heard once we get up to the top,
We still got to walk a little bit to get to the colony, so it's not 100% there. I think we're actually getting 3/4 of the way there via the horse. It's about 15 to 20 minutes to get up there. So the view has just been incredible all the way up this green, lush forest. It rained yesterday, so it's a little bit muddy. But it's just the higher we go, the more beautiful it gets. So my mom was the first one to notice the butterflies. So we're now in a more open area. I can see that here where the horses are being left, and I can already see the butterflies flying around everywhere. There's so many of them, and there's still so much more higher to go. Obviously, I don't think we're gonna get to the top, but I don't know, I think we're very close because I can just see them everywhere at this point. I know there's no way you guys are gonna be able to see that detail, so we're obviously gonna get closer, but right above the forest line, there are probably, I don't know, thousands of butterflies that are flying up there. I hope we can get close. I hope they're flying around a little bit closer to the ground. I can see them. It's just, I don't know, it's unbelievable. You guys can't see the smile under my mask, so yeah, here we go.
¿Cuál es la mala? Esta. ¿Está buena? Sí. Están buenas. Todavía la aguantan. Las rodillas.
It was such a great day to come today. We came on a Thursday. You know, when we got rained out, that was actually Tuesday. So it's actually really great because there's not a lot of people and we really just got to enjoy it, the few of us. Our guide, because you get assigned a guide when you come here, told us that it's still a 15 to 20 minute walk from here. So no horses from here. I'm not actually able to see as many butterflies here as I thought because when we were out in the open, you could see them with the contrast of the big blue sky. But here, I'm hoping that we're walking up to a more densely populated part of the forest where we can see them. So this is the kind of place that, you know, it's like you just want to keep hiking higher and higher because it just becomes, I just want to know what's around the corner. I mean, it's already so beautiful on the way up here. And then the butterflies are, they're starting to show up in numerous amounts. And my brother was like, we care about seeing butterflies, but I think it's more about the nature and the fact that they come here from so far. And, you know, it takes 4 generations from Mexico to the US to Canada and then all the way back, that I think it's kind of incredible. And oh, I had not looked up. Oh my God, we're surrounded by them. They're everywhere. And because there is a cloud above us, I hope you're gonna be able to see it on the camera.
Thank you.
All right, everyone, it cleared out behind me. I'm not sure if you're gonna be able to see them from here because the sun went away. And what happens is when the sun goes away, they will clump together in the tree. And actually, there's so many of them and so heavy that they actually pull down the branches from the tree. Actually, at the peak, when the sun was at its brightest, and we got a little bit of a, we got some sunshine up here, you could hear, I wish that I could, I hope that I was able to record it, you could hear the thousands of butterfly wings that were just flapping in the wind. It was pretty unbelievable to just listen to it. It's just, this was such a unique experience for me. This is actually a natural smile. I'm not forcing. And I don't know. I'm just really happy to have, like, I guess I'm happy to be able to be sharing this experience with my parents, but also at the same time, as I'm discovering these new places and these new experiences, to sharing it with all of you guys. I don't know how else to put it. That's the whole purpose of my videos, is to be able to share these experiences as they happen. And I don't know how else to put it. So we're on our way back down. We're gonna hop back on the horse, and I don't know, we're probably gonna get something to eat. Let me know if you like this video. I really wanna hear from you guys. I really enjoy hearing from you guys. I answer as many of the comments. Not as much, like, I answer all the comments. If you leave me a comment, I'm gonna leave you a reply. So I like to hear from you guys. Is there anything you guys wanna see next? Is there anything you're curious about? Do you have any questions? I know some of my friends are like, yeah, you're on permanent vacation. Kinda. If you wanna know more, like, what's going on with me, I mean, I guess I haven't talked about that, let me know. I hope you guys like this video. As I always say, don't forget to like and subscribe. And also, don't forget to hit the little bell. I never tell anyone to hit that bell, but if you don't hit that notification bell, you don't get to see my videos. So yeah, as always, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.